Haseem Rahman is responding to what Jake Paul said. Jake Paul was saying that Haseem Rahman is the most unprofessional person he ever dealt with. He also said, everybody else, warning, do not put Haseem Rahman on your cards. So Rahman is responding to that. He says, why he don't have this energy in person though? Biggest payday of my life? Haseem Rahman asks, and he answers his own question. I already made 4 times what you offered off of sparring. Now you want to paint the narrative to not let me on anyone else, anyone's cards, because you know the people going demand us. And he does, hashtag Jake fraud. So there's going to be a back and forth here. There's going to be a lot of versions to what really happened. Unfortunately, the bottom line is the fight's not happening. And that's unfortunate. Because me personally, and you, anybody watching this video, was looking forward to this. We wanted to see how does Jake do with, quote unquote, a real boxer. How does Jake do with someone that has 100 amateur fights when he has no amateur fights? How does Jake do with someone that has 13 pro fights when he only has 5 pro fights? How does he do with someone who's born into boxing, that his dad's a legend, his dad was undisputed heavyweight champ who beat Lennox Lewis? So here's what Jake said that got Haseem Rahman to respond. He said, all jokes aside, I can't believe how much of a B Haseem is and how stupid he is for ruining the biggest opportunity and the biggest payday that he will ever get in his life. For anyone who is thinking about getting Haseem to fight on any of your cards, do yourself a big favor and don't. Him and his team are the most unprofessional people any of us have ever worked with. A nightmare. Between him and Tommy, they have cost me and my partners millions and millions of dollars. So this is what Jake Paul said. You saw the response of Haseem Rahman saying something to the extent of, people are going to demand that we fight now. Like, they would want to see that fight. I don't know. I don't know what Jake does next. I don't know what Haseem Rahman does next. I know it's unfortunate that the fight's not happening. That's the bottom line. And I feel bad for anybody that was on that card. Because I can tell you guys right now, if you're a pro fighter fighting on a Jake Paul card, you are going to get paid. Normally, fighters start out, make $5,000, $3,000, $500. Mike Tyson made $500 for his pro debut. He actually made less. $500 is what some fan gave him. But most people, when they start out their career, first few fights, first 10 fights, 12, 15, 16 fights, not making money. But you fight on a Jake Paul card, you're making 50, 60, 70,000 to fight on the undercard. I'm talking about guys who are just starting their career. Some people think that's normal. So I feel bad for anybody like that, because this was their biggest payday and their biggest opportunity. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. Right now, the fight next weekend is canceled. It's officially off. This is not a publicity stunt. This is not fake. It's everything's been canceled. So we'll keep you guys updated on the latest. But right now, Virgil Ortiz is fighting on the 6th in Fort Worth. 18-0, 18 knockouts. Then you have Adrian Broner fighting on the 20th. You have Teofimo Lopez fighting on the 13th. You have Joshua Usyk on the 20th in Saudi Arabia. You have Broner's fighting in Hollywood, Florida. Teofimo's fighting in Vegas. So lots of boxing coming, and a lot of fight cancellations as of late. So hopefully the rest of the fights this year happen. We'll keep you guys, like I said, updated on the latest. That's why you are here on ES News. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. I'm Ellie Secback. Ellie Secback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.